morning, Nika.
We're having a lot of people in today.
Yes, well, it's always the same on Saints Day.
A celebration. Don't you like it?
Yeah, very good for business.
Me, I enjoy it. It's a day to thank God one was born a Christian and denies Nicolaus.
Then shouldn't you have been in church this morning, Nika?
Oh, Mrs. Shepherd, I give thanks. Truly, I do. But I'm not a fanatic, you understand?
We'll need some more tables and chairs outside.
Leave it to me.
Nick, I don't know quite where this is the best place for that. We're going to get crowded later. Over there, what do you think?
Oh, just a minute. Cigarettes.
Where are you two going?
Along to the harbour to see some more of the fun.
We're going to be busy today.
Who's covering his day off?
Well, Nico and I can't manage alone.
Well, I'll be back.
When?
I don't know, half an hour maybe.
I think you see too much of Katerina, Eric. She's a child.
I seem to remember telling you that. And probably that's why I enjoy being with her. It's nearest I'm going to get to being a father anyway, it seems.
Sick, Eric. The way things were when we first got married, I mean, what kind of a father do you think you'd have made?
I don't know, and you made damn sure I couldn't find out.
You blame me?
But what about afterwards?
There were reasons.
Yes, but no explanations.
Sorry.
Yes, so am I.
I shall need some small change for the till. You've got the key to the drawer. Eric, you may need Katerina, but she doesn't need you.
Well, perhaps not.
You're using her, then?
Well, just so long as it pleases her. It's quite harmless.
You said that once before.
Now, look, Anne, once and for all, I was acquitted.
Couldn't it have waited?
No, I'm sorry. I had to talk to you.
Well, is that important?
Yes.
So?
Well, it's not easy. It's about Anne.
What about my wife? Well?
Well, it's so simple, really. A question of fact, but... Well, it's hard to find the right words.
Oh, for God's sake, man. Forget the semantics. Just say what you've got to say.
All right. Anne and I are in love.
You're a liar.
No. It's the truth.
Since when?
For me, since the first time I came here.
And I?
Well, the same, I think. Well, I wasn't sure then. I believe she is now.
You think? You believe? I mean, has she told you that she loves you?
No, not in so many words, but she is.
How can you be so sure, then?
I'm sure. Let's leave it at that.
I see. So that's why you came back to the island. Take my wife away from me.
If I could, yes.
You bastard.
Sorry.
Sorry? You come back here with a deliberate intention of ruining my marriage, and then you say you're sorry.
Look, it wasn't like
you that. Think that's something you can just apologize for, and that makes it
all right. I was in love with Anne when I came back. But I wouldn't have done anything about it if I felt you two had anything going for you. But there isn't anything to destroy. You don't think Anne would have responded if there had been?
And she did.
Are you surprised?
Look, what the hell are you talking about?
What kind of a life has a beaver? How many women have you had affairs with since you were married? And that scandal back in England when the girl got murdered. You dragged her through that.
Oh, you're very well informed.
Anne's told me everything. What have you ever given her? What were you when she met you? An alcoholic?
Oh,
yes! Stop! And you're still an alcoholic. All right, you've been dry for 7 years, but one drink and you're back where you started. Do you really expect her to live the rest of her life without hanging over? If you feel anything for her at all, you've got to let her go. I want her to come away with me. She's in love with me.
You think?
Look, I told you, I'm sure.
I don't believe
you. But you must.
Well, just because you say so.
All right. I didn't want to hurt you any more than I had to, but sooner or later you'd have to know. Anne and I are lovers. We've been to bed together.
Oh, you bastard. You...
You asked her! Ask her.
What did you say to him?
That we're in love. That you and I are lovers.
What?
And he believes it.
But why? It isn't true, any of it. Yes, all right, we did go to bed together.
Yes, we did go to bed.
But we're not lovers.
The intent was there, and we went to bed. Legally, there's no difference.
There's a bloody big difference. You couldn't make it, remember? And I was glad you couldn't, because suddenly being in bed with you, I felt dirty and ashamed because I don't love you. And I didn't want to hit back at Eric in that way.
Eric doesn't know that.
Bastard. Is this your way of getting back at me? Because I threw you out.
No. That's unimportant.
You any idea what this will do to him? He'll fall apart.
Almost certainly.
He'll end up in a bar somewhere and he'll get drunk.
That's right.
Don't you understand? It could destroy him.
Probably. But that's not my concern. And it's no longer yours.
What do you mean?
I told you when I first came here that the waiting would soon be over. Well, now it is. That's why I'm here. That's why I was sent back. The last 10 years are over and done with. They've served their purpose for us and for Judith Huxley.
The service is fortunate in having recruited you. Judy Huxley is officially dead. You are now Anne Cherrick. We will train you in your new identity. You have all the right qualifications, stable background, first-class degree in modern languages, and no ties.
Tell me about Pardubice.
Pardubice is a town in northern Bohemia.
In Czech!
Pardubice je město v severních Čechách, 96 kilometrů od Prahy. Má 66 tisíc obyvatel. Je tam gotický kostel ze 13. století.
What is your name?
My name is Anne Czernik. I was born in Prague on the 3rd of January 1937. My father was Josef Czernik, born in Pardubice in northern Bohemia in 1906.
You are now Anne Czernik. You must think like Anne Czernik. You must act like Anne Czernik. You must be Anne Czernik at all times. We will establish a cover for you that no one can break. It is important that you marry. We have someone in mind. His name is Eric Shepherd.
He's an alcoholic.
He desperately needs someone to lean on, to hang on to. Marry him. He'll make life hell for you. Which is exactly what we want. You will not be operational right away. You will be a sleeper. Go anywhere you like. Take up your life as Anne Czernik. And wait, You will have no contact with us whatever. But we will know where to find you. With a difficult marriage, no one will remark on your suddenly leaving your husband.
You said you came back because of me. That I meant something to you. And you couldn't stay away. Well, you lied.
It was to make it easier for him.
Like
it
him.
Didn't work.
Close to believing you.
But not close enough. So I had to find another way.
Oh, God, it's a lousy business, yours.
Ours.
It's dirty and it's cruel.
Look, it's not a game we're playing. There aren't any rules.
Doesn't matter how many people get hurt.
But you never loved Eric. He was chosen for you. Just another part of your cover.
He's changed since he's been on Crete. I've watched it happening. He's grown. He's much more self-confident.
No. No, he hasn't changed. It's all surface than he likes Shepherd.
He wasn't drinking. That must have been a blow for you.
No, not really. I've been warned that he might be dry, but apparently... Well, apparently that doesn't mean much. Not to someone with his kind of history. I knew that if I pushed hard enough when the moment came, he'd reach for the bottle again.
So the day you pushed...
Yes, and you said it yourself. He's headed straight for a bar.
Well, maybe we'll both be proved wrong.
You don't really believe that, do you?
No. So, this is what you're leading up to all the time, is it?
Of course. You knew sooner or later this would happen.
Not this way.
A trigger was needed, a match to the kindling. That's my function.
And what's mine?
I told you, that's setting up a job for you. Now it's set up. They need you.
Has it occurred to you that I might have changed?
Well, of course you have. They expected it.
Well, what if I don't want to go on this mission?
You have no alternative. This is what you were trained for. You're committed.
To hell with commitment. What if I say no?
As you rightly said, it's a lousy business.
So?
Eric's taken a hell of a beating already. What do you suppose would happen to him if he were told the truth? Everything. Exactly what he's been these past 10 years. That because of what he was and is, he was chosen to be part of a cover story. That the woman he married was never Anne Czernik, but somebody called
Judith Huxley. That he was just one more lie in a chain of deception, and this was done to him with your knowledge and your full cooperation.
He would be told.
That wouldn't be my decision.
But he might.
Yes, he might. And that's something to think about, isn't it? You let me know what you decide.
When would we leave?
Just as soon as Eric gets back. And you confirm what I told him.
I said Eric, he's missing all the fun.
Oh, that's right, absolutely right. It's a very festive occasion.
Yeah.
I might take a stroll later on. Join the celebration.
Why not? I shouldn't bother to come back.
I see. So you've made up your mind then?
Yes. Yes, I've made up my mind. I'm not going with you.
And the consequences of that decision?
Your threat to tell Eric about me? Well, I'm going to save the department the trouble. I'm going to tell him myself.
Why tell him at all? Why not just say to hell with him, with us? Why not just clear out? Why stay?
Because he needs me. And because I want to. And because there's always the chance that someone like you will come along and tell him, and I want to be here to try and explain.
And how do you think Eric's going to take this? With an understanding smile?
No, he'll be upset and he'll be angry. But if he's angry enough, he'll survive.
And when he stops being angry?
Then I'll be here if he needs me.
Ready to settle down to a life of domestic bliss?
No. No, we're neither of us that type. We'll fight often. But at least we'll have a greater chance of happiness because he'll know that the shadow that's kept us apart all these years has been the shadow of my past, not his.
Yes, but the drinking, you still have that problem.
I've seen him through it before. I'll do it again.
So that's your answer, is it? Final and irrevocable?
Yes.
Your obligations to the service, they aren't important.
Totally.
And to your country?
Changing tack.
Yes, I was even thinking of using old-fashioned words like loyalty.
Well, please don't, because coming from you, I find them a little difficult. So, that's it. I'm opting out. What are you going to do about it?
What can I do about it? A great deal of time and money was spent on your training.
But in your present state of mind, you would have been a little used to it. Still, I had to try.
You threatened to expose
me. No. We'd never have done that. But you mustn't tell Eric either. Not if you plan to return to England, that is. You sign the Official Secrets Act, remember?
But I have to tell.
No. Not ever. You've lived a lie for the last 10 years. They're just going to have to go on living it. But that's the only penalty you'll have to pay. I shan't be seeing you again. Goodbye. No, of course not.
Nico, it's time you went home. I'll finish up here.
Only if you're very sure, Mr. Shepherd.
Yes, I'm sure. I'm sorry it's been such a hard day for you.
That's all right. Kalinita.
Kalinita.
Έχει στραγγαλιστεί.
What is it, Nico?
Katerina. Katerina is dead. They found her body in the harbor this morning. Someone has killed her.
You know about Katerina?
Yes, I know. Eric's not here.
I know that. He's in jail.
Sir.
May I? May I have a brandy?
What?
I find I have little stomach for murder. She was a pretty girl.
I didn't like her that much. Did you know that?
You were afraid of her?
Yes, perhaps I was a little.
Or for her?
Why should I be afraid for her?
Because of her husband and his interest in her. Oh, and I know about Eric. I knew within a month of your applying for residence permits here. It's all on his file in my office. In 1964 in England, he was tried for the murder of a 15-year-old girl named Carol Sadler. A girl he had taught to sail, a girl who was often in his company, and a girl who I think you also did not like.
He was acquitted.
Yes. But many people where you lived, they thought Eric was guilty, didn't they?
Yes, a few.
Katerina was 15 years old, and like the other girls, she was also strangled. That's not unusual. A man attacks a girl, she screams, he puts his hand around her throat. As I say, it's not unusual. But it is another coincidence.
I'm to blame, Michael.
For what?
For what's happened. For what happened to Carol Sadler, even.
Why? How can that be, if your husband is innocent? Look, I talked to Eric once about what happened in England. He told me he didn't kill the Sadler girl, and I believed him. I still believe him.
But you said he was in jail.
He is. At the Rapetre. He was picked up by the police there last night because he was drunk. I received a telephone call this morning to say they kept him in the cells overnight for his own protection, you understand? There won't be any charges. That's what I came to tell you.
Katerina?
You didn't think that Eric had killed the child he loved, did you? Oh, Anne. Such torment. And for so many years.
Are you certain?
Quite certain. Katerina Pavlakis was alive at 2:30 this morning. There are witnesses to that fact. And at 2:30, your husband had already been in jail for 1 hour 25 miles from here at the Rapetre.
Oh, God.
It is strange, is it not? First, a man, a good man who mustn't drink, gets drunk. For what reason, I do not know. Then a young girl he is close to is murdered, and in such a way as to point to him as her killer through his past. It's almost as though someone was trying to harm Eric. Well, that's absurd, of course. Who would do such a thing? Who in Ayers Nikolaos, apart from you and I, knows about his past? There is much I must do. Expect to see you here.
What is it? Something wrong?
You didn't give up, did you? It was you. You killed Katerina.
Katerina?
You knew I wasn't sure, that I'd never been sure, so you used that doubt.
What are you talking about? I didn't even know Katerina was dead.
It didn't matter whether Eric was put in jail again or not, even if he was put on trial. You knew the suspicion would be there, in my mind, like before. And you knew that suspicion would be enough.
you thought it would make me leave Eric and go to London and go on your mission for you. You know something? It nearly worked. But you made a mistake. A big one. Eric was in jail last night, 25 miles from here. So he couldn't have killed her, could he? And listen to this. This is the funniest thing of all. He was in jail because he was drunk. And it was you who made him drunk. Isn't that funny? But it's no good, is it? You won't give up. Well, I'm not going to let you hurt Eric anymore. He's been hurt and he's been used. And it's got to stop. I've used him and you've used him. And I'm not going to let you hurt him or use him anymore.
No. No, he won't be hurt anymore. I'll get on to London. I'll tell them. No one will make any more trouble for you. Not for you. Not for Eric.
No. You mustn't make any more trouble for Eric, you promise?
Yes, I promise.
Because I love him, you see. I didn't tell you that before, did I? I didn't hurt myself until now, but I do.
I promise.
I love him.
Heard about Katrina?
Yes.
What can I say?
Nothing.
And now this. There could be connection. There are scratches on Kali's arms and neck. They were made recently, but not within the last hour or so. They are the kind of scratches a girl would make during a struggle. We'll find out. You were not particularly friendly with Kali, were you?
He was a customer.
Not a friend?
No.
But Anne liked him, didn't she?
Yes, I think so.
Well, she was often in his company.
She found him amusing, I think.
Did she? Have you been back to the bar since you returned from your Petra?
Yes, there was no one there.
Not even Anne?
No.
Then go home, my friend. I think you'll be needed there.
Anne? Anne? Oh, my God, no.
You are not thinking of clearing harbour without telling me, were you?
No, of course not.
You were going to call at my office before you went?
Naturally.
Naturally? Annie's not well?
No, she's not, but I think she'll be all right.
So you thought the sea air would do her good?
Yeah, something like that.
Did you know that I wish to speak to her?
No, what about?
About Mr. Cully? Did you?
Look, she could tell you nothing.
Perhaps you're right. Nothing I didn't know already anyway. Is this what you want? Cully interested me. Professionally, I mean. There was something about him. Something I did not like. I couldn't say what it was, but there was something. When he first came, I often said to myself, what's he doing here? What does he want in Ayers Nikolaos, this man who calls himself a journalist, who talks to so many people, who asks so many questions, but who writes so little? And I could find no answer that made me content. And then he returned, and many strange things happened. He interested our security police in Athens also. That is why they are sending two of the men here to make inquiries about him. They will want to talk to you both, I expect. But they will not be here until late this evening. So it would not be until tomorrow that they'll call at the bar. I'll bring them myself.
And if we're not there?
Then I'll have to start looking for you. Won't I? It is necessary that you take this with you?
Yes.
A pity. Are you sure she'll be all right?
Sure comes right.
There are questions he will want answered.
Well, tomorrow, the next day, sometime, when she's ready.
You may not like what she tells you.
I have to live with it. I need her. I think she needs me. We're all we've got.
A libation for Poseidon, the god of the sea, in return for calm waters.
How do I say thank you?
It is not necessary. We both know that only in this way is there any real justice.
Just one more favor.
Yes.
When do they bury Katerina?
The day after tomorrow.
I'd like there to be something there from me.
I'll see to it.
And a card.
Apoeno agapito filo. From a loving friend.
Yeah.
Calm waters. For both of you.
Fare sto.